It's a huge joy to open this exhibition of his new work, Empire Land, by Mark McKelly. And last year, the right thing evolved, and Mark and I started working on a proposal for a big public artwork. And we really thought about what the public is, what it is to create images, what images are already out there. And from that, we developed this idea of bringing that idea of publicness back into the gallery.
The piece is called Empire Land, and it's a visual word. You know, there are words that we see visually in public space. This brings you immediately into the world of signs and semiotics. And the nature of these signs is that they become ubiquitous and they become invisible. And that's the nature, I suppose, of even a term like Ireland, which that becomes kind of invisible. When we were thinking about this project, we were thinking about that idea of public space. And in public space, there is an automatic assumption of a kind of a democracy that should exist, a care for the other, a protocol of behavior in the world. And this is exemplified, I think, in terms of things like the motorway systems of a country, the physical infrastructure of a country, and the codes and the language that is utilized in those things has a kind of presumed innocence about it. My idea in terms of this piece was to try to interact with that kind of language and to deal with the kind of loaded concept to make artworks which could somehow be accommodated within the idea of the public realm, that they would take on notions of history, notions of things that actually are quite controversial, things that are actually under debate, and things that are in a state of revision and revolution, and apply this language that's designed to promote ideas of public safety, harmony, and the efficient circulation of goods, people, and services in a modern democratic society. This kind of swoosh movement then, I suppose, that's in it. I mean, this takes you around the composition in a circular fashion, which again has a double, triple meaning. We can think of it as a roadway, think of it almost as a system of information being gathered and distributed. It interacts with these objects, these kiosk-like objects, these kind of tower-like objects, which we can also think of like as aerials or antennas. This movement is borrowed from the packaging of pharmaceuticals. And so the zero in this case becomes more pill-shaped, something quite palatable, something which is there to alleviate the anxieties of life and working as a citizen in a modern economy. X's and circles, very sort of digital language pervades the work at a very subtle level. Everything forms into an X, which is a sign of like, you are here. It's also a sign of like a kiss, a negation, something being crossed out, or like the mark of an individual. When I did finally see the piece as one, these kind of codes are very good in terms of narrating the movement across the surface. But as the work evolved and revolved in some way, the image that it became clear, which wasn't in the drawings, you know, in a way that made sense to show this group, almost like a parliament of figures who I feel are important, was actually the group who in the early 1980s and 1983 really made a bold stand, and they were the strikers who refused to handle South African products in Dunn stores. That was really what set the fuse, that set up a whole series of international relations and a new proclamation or declaration of a certain kind of consciousness of thinking within the trade union movement, I suppose, in Ireland, in terms of our relationship in 1983 with global trade and the import and export of goods from other places. And so that's the nature of this language. I intend people to see the double meanings, the contradictory meanings, and the paradoxical meanings in the application of imagery, particularly in terms of how it interacts with each other. And that's what makes, I suppose, the work of art or a painting or a sculpture very different from just the utilitarian use of language and signage. So the work also deals with these macro issues, but then also tries to think about the effects of that on the formation of the subject of the state, which is the citizen.